Hello and welcome to this episode of Makerbox Mondays. Today I'm going to have a look at Polymax PETG from Polymaker. So let's have a look after the intro. So this filament is a Polymax PETG from Polymaker. Here on the label they say the print temperature should be 230 to 240, and I was printing at 230. Bed temperature 70 to 80 and speed 30 to 50 and fan off or low, so pretty much normal PETG settings, I would say. Here they say Polymaker advises build tack or PI. We have found PETG can weld to those surfaces and advise glue stick as an interface. And I was using my PETG sheet with Magico on. Here they say also is Polymax is a family of advanced 3D printing filament produced with Polymaker's nano reinforced technology to deliver exceptional mechanical properties and printing quality. Polymax PETG offers better mechanical properties than any other regular PETG, making it a good candidate for a wide range of applications. You can see more information at polymaker.com. So let's have a look at the prints. And I first did the normal stringing test I do, and it came out pretty good. Some stringing as usual with PETG, but the strands are pretty strong. It's quite difficult to break, so layer adhesion seems to be really good with this filament. It's quite stiff, so that's a good sign. And then printed out Mr. Belly, and that came out excellent, absolutely no issues. I normally get a little bit of drooping at this point, and here's one loop of drooping. That's pretty normal, but otherwise it's quite strong. It's not very brittle, but I'm normally manage to break this guy off. It's like a print test that I break him apart. Then did my maker coin. And here you can see a little booger, just a black strain of some burnt filament from the hot end. It's no fault of the filament itself, it's just something that was accumulating on the hot end, so don't mind that. But otherwise print quality was excellent, and it's really smooth surface, and letters came out good, and it came out really nice. Just the black streak throughout the print was something on the hot end. Then printed out the Benzi, and that came out excellent as well. Overhangs here on the front came out excellent, even though part cooling was very little. It was like 30%, so the overhangs came out excellent. I was like sometimes issues with cooling on the side of Benzis, but it came out pretty good and no issues. So that came out excellent. And then finally Sear Laser Lot, that came out excellent, absolutely no issues. That one, really clean print, and no issues. It's hollow inside, but it looks pretty good and very smooth, and seems to be very consistent layers. Like here it's pretty consistent. So I think the filament is doing a good job, and it's pretty strong. It's rather stiff material, and I didn't do any break tests to check it compared to other PETGs I have, but based on this one it seems to be pretty strong, so it was giving me good results. So that was my quick look at Polymax PETG from Polymaker. It turned out to be really easy to use and seems to be rather strong material in my simple breaks test I did. Seemed to be pretty strong compared to other PETGs, so I think they have the nano reinforcement technology, whatever that means. I don't go into any detail on how that works, but it seems to do something at least compared to some other print materials I have tested. So I was quite happy with this filament. But this will be it for this video. I'm Martin, and this is 3D Printing Iceland. If you like what I'm doing here on the channel, please give this video a thumbs up or a like or a comment or a subscribe. to my channel, so if you want to see more. But for now, I thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.